simple cane post sitting down by the creek. Lines in the water, watching those bobbers, seeing that red sun sink. Mama's on the porch yelling, supper's hot, y'all come and get it. We yelled five more minutes. At 16, it was 12:03, standing at her front door. And Katie's dad said midnight, but we needed just a little more. Yellow light flipping on and off, interrupting that goodnight kissing. We wanted five more minutes. Time rolls by, the clock don't stop. I wish I had a few more drops of the good stuff, the good times. Oh, but they just keep on flying right on by like it ain't nothing. I wish I had me a pause. Give myself five more minutes. At 18, turn my helmet in, walk to the 50-yard line. Just the coach and me after we lost 8-10-9. And I cried, man, next time to get in here, I'll have to buy a ticket. Can't you give me five? Grandpa said, there's angels in the room. All the family gathered round, knew the time was coming soon. With so much left to say, I prayed, Lord, I ain't finished. Just give us five more minutes. Time rolls by, the clock don't stop. I wish I had a few more drops of the good stuff. Just keep on flying right on by like it ain't nothing. I wish I had me a pause button. Moments like those, Lord knows I'd hit it. Yeah, sometimes this old life will leave you wishing that you had five more minutes.
My grandmama was a wise old soul, took me by the hand not long ago. Said, son, watch your hurry, boy, slow it down. Taste the wild honey, listen to the sound of the wind that's blowing through the trees. Rivers flow into the sea. Yeah, they're all heading home just like you and me. Life's for living, child, can't you see? These are the days we will remember, and these are the times that won't come again. The highest of flames becomes an ember, and you gotta live while you can. These are the days we will I hope the days come easy and the moments pass slow, and each road leads you where you wanna go. And if you're faced with a choice and you have to choose, I hope you choose the one that means the most to you. And if one door opens to another door closed, I hope you keep on walking till you find the window. If it's cold outside, show the world the warmth of your smile. But more than anything, my wish for you is that this life becomes all that you want it to. Your dreams stay big, your worries stay small. You never need to carry more than you can hold. And while you're out there getting where you're getting to, I hope you know somebody loves you and wants the same things too. Yeah, this is my wish. I hope you never look back, but you never forget all the ones who love you in the place you left. I hope you always forgive and you never regret, and you help somebody every chance you get. Oh, you find God's grace in every mistake, and always give more than you take. But more than anything, yeah, more than anything, my wish for you is that this life.
Before I begin, I want to apologize in advance. Last year, I took a public speaking course for leadership, and one thing I learned was to never say sorry when you mess up in a speech. So I'm saying it now in advance, just in case I do. Now, this speech won't be long, as I'm only the welcoming speech, but I'm hoping to provide you with a little entertainment while I'm here. When I first found out I had to give a speech, my first thought was to wing it. I always believed that the most heartfelt speeches were in the moment. Turns out, I'm not allowed to wing it. I had to have a speech written and turned in the day before graduation to make sure it was school appropriate. I'm glad that rule's in place now, because there's a lot of people here and I probably would have choked up. My next idea was to write one with the help of my English teacher, Mr. Deckelman. Long story short, that never happened, and all of my ideas about writing a speech were forgotten until 2 days ago when I finally started to write it. As I began to draft my speech, I couldn't figure out what to write. Everything that came to mind was either boring or cliche. I went back and forth on whether I wanted to be a powerful and uplifting one or more on the humorous side. I figured I should go with humor because the only speeches I remember from past graduations were the ones that made me laugh. Now, I may not be the funniest guy in school, but hopefully I'll be able to make you laugh a little bit. With that being said, I'm going to tell you a story. The story I'm going to tell is what I believe to be a very valuable learning experience. As a joke, my girlfriend and I, Mackenzie, were looking at kittens on Craigslist for about a week or two. We would tell our parents that one day they'd come home and there'd be a new cat in the house. It's every parent's most favorite thing to hear from any student ever. At first I saw it as no more than looking at cute cats, but one day we saw this really, really cute kitten for sale in Rainier. Me, being the persuasive person I am, I got Mackenzie to call the people, and the next thing we knew, we were on our way to Rainier. To shorten the rest of the story, we did buy that kitten without telling either of our parents. We were told that we couldn't keep the kitten by both of our parents, and you can probably guess what happened next. We kept him. The valuable life lesson I learned from this situation is that if you cry in front of your girlfriend's mom, you can pretty much get whatever you want. Might not be the best life lesson, but I believe the manly tears that were shed helped persuade her mom into letting her keep him. Now, I know my story wasn't about any of my high school experiences, but I do hope that I was able to put a smile on at least one person's face. Once again, thank you all for coming, and congratulations to the graduating class of 2018. Now please rise as our chamber choir sings the national anthem.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proud twilight's last gleaming, whose rough stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming.
And welcome to Skypiece High School's commencement ceremony for the class of 2018. I'm Jim Jones, the principal of Skypiece High School. I'm very pleased to be here with all of you to celebrate this memorable afternoon. First off, I'd like to thank our chamber choir for their outstanding performance of the national anthem. At this time, I would like to introduce our guests who are sharing the stage this afternoon. I'll start by introducing our school board members who give freely and generously of their time and service to all of us. Board Chair Phil Lager. Jim Hogue. Andrew Michelle. Michelle Graham. Tim Brooks. Will Kessie. And Lisa Maloney. Thank you to Assistant Principals Brad McKitty and Robert Medley, and to our counselors Whitney Scott, Eric Kingstaff, and Brittany Phillips. Unfortunately, that was not staged. Turn that off. Everybody silence your phones. All right, where were we? Thank you to our activities director and graduation advisor, Courtney Scott, and our registrar, Joseph Bradley, and to those staff members who have worked hard to plan, organize, and attend to the many details to make graduation a successful ceremony. I'm also pleased to recognize our outstanding teachers and support staff, both at SHS and throughout our school district. Your skills, hard work, and passion for helping students have made this day possible for our seniors. If you're a staff member of Skypiece High School in the Skypiece School District, please stand. And finally, and with much appreciation, the graduating class would like to recognize the parents and guardians of the class of 2018 for the tremendous support you've given your students and our schools over the years. Parents and guardians of the class of 2018, please stand and remain standing for a moment so we may acknowledge and thank you. Be seated, please. So, seniors, after four great years at SHS, I would like to publicly commend this class for your outstanding contributions to Skypiece High School. You have been special. Those of us who work in schools know that high school is a time to develop intellectually, emotionally, as well as personally. We talk to our students all the time about making the right choices and being people of high character. You have done that. This group has positively impacted our school culture with their accepting, caring, and inviting leadership. I have no doubt you will go on and have the same impact and make the same positive contributions to your community, just like you have at Skypiece High School. I also would like to recap some of the highlights of our senior class. We have students sitting here tonight who are going to some of the top academic colleges in the country, and over 90% of them are enrolling in some type of post-secondary education, military, or trade school. I believe you'll see this outstanding group of young men and women are already very accomplished. Let me give you some examples. This class has earned over $1,920,000 in scholarships. We're expecting a record number of college credits earned through AP and dual credit options. We're recognized statewide for our athletics, activities, and arts. We continue to compete at the highest level in our league and at state. In just this past year, Scappoose has accomplished the following. Girls cross country finished as state runner-ups. John Kukulich became the first student in Scappoose history to win an individual state title in cross country. Football, volleyball, and girls soccer were all state quarterfinalists. Men's wrestling produced a number of state place winners, and our women's wrestling program competed courageously in their inaugural year with senior Carly Reagan leading the charge. Softball earned a Quapa League championship for the first time in over a decade, and our band also won a Quapa League championship. Boys track finished third in state with John Kavulich and the 4x100 relay team earning individual state titles. Boys golf finished second in state. Girls track was seventh in state with Linnea Kavulich winning state titles in the 1500 and the 200. It gives me great pleasure to recognize our salutatorian and our valedictorian. This year our salutatorians include Mackenzie Ela, Christina Perry, and Benjamin Warren. Our valedictorians are John and Linnea Kavulich. I would like to introduce Ben Warren, John Kavulich, and Linnea Kavulich. These students will now address their class.
What's up? You know what? The speech kind of sucked anyway, so I'm gonna try a slightly different road here. Good morning, Scappoose High School! And Scappoose the town. So, I'm walking down the hall the other day, Miss Scott pulls me into her office. Is everything okay, Miss Scott, I ask? She looks at me grimly, like a grizzly bear ate her child, only that I was the grizzly. I'm petrified in this moment. And then she smiles really widely and tells me I'm a salutatorian and that I have to give a really awkward speech at graduation. Then I looked at her and I said, nice. Before I get super deep, there are several shout-outs I've promised to some people over the years. First, I have to shout out to my father, Petty Officer Joseph Warren, ET2, for being the most honorable man I've ever met. Yeah! I also got a shout out to my grandparents for their endless support and loving help, my brothers for pushing me to see outside my own skull, my mother for teaching me to practice magic and to be in love with life, and Will Broderick for being an awesome leader to us and a great friend to me, and for the friends I have in front of me for having taught me so incredibly many life lessons over the past 6 years. I also have to shout out Allison Vanderzander because 4 years ago I promised her I would. I've always been a very passionate person, and one of my deepest passions has always been living life. Now that we're all here, it's the critical moment we should consider that now we'll forever have our own freedom, regardless of the responsibilities. And there will be nobody who can push you to enjoy yourself other than your own self. We forge who we are, and the stronger you forge yourself, the more light you will shine on the world and others around you. My advice is, don't wait to start forging yourself into the person you've always dreamt you would be. This includes your own character. See, I always wanted to be the sort of person that's a mix up of, say, Einstein, Randy Pink Floyd, Buddha, Humphrey Bogart, Ferris Bueller, and one day, Jackie Chan. There is no other time than now, and no one is going to enjoy your life for you. So if you want to do something, if you want to be somebody that does something amazing, steal character traits from people you admire, and be your own personal hero. While we're talking about life, I want to hit on something I'm not sure if anybody else will mention today, but I feel is the crutch of life. And that's taking the time to enjoy yourself. You see, a good friend of mine once said, life moves pretty fast, and if you don't stop to look around once in a while, you can miss it. I mean, the point of getting a house, going to college, getting a spouse, and getting a money-paying job is, I mean, it's ultimately to enjoy yourself, isn't it? Your parents, your colleagues, many will say that what matters is hard work and perseverance. And this is absolutely true. However, keep in mind, you shouldn't take life too seriously. It's not like you're going to get out alive. There's one thing I wake up and I think about every morning, and that's that on my deathbed, I'm going to regret more of the things I didn't do than the things that I did. See, we may never pass this way again. So if there's something you want to do, something big today, or even something small, go for it, because it might not be there tomorrow. Speaking of, it might not be available tomorrow. When I say 20, you say 18. 20! 20! 20! 20! Friends and teachers, ladies and gentlemen, males and females, and Apache attack helicopters. I hope that I've made at least half the impact on you as you've had on me. This is Ben Warren, signing off.
Don't worry, it's all of you. All right. So one night I was writing my application essay for Princeton. Yeah, it's a very prestigious, like, thing you expect, though, but not. Except I didn't get any. Anyway, I found an article about a very ordinary woman who approaches life in a very extraordinary way. Upon losing her husband, she filled a jar with marbles, each representing a week of her life. Every week, she took a marble out. Now, since today is Saturday, and for some of us, the end of the week, depending on whether you make the week starts on Sunday or Monday, this is only fitting. Now, most of us here, at least the people in front of me, are about 18 years old. The average human lifespan is about 79 years, if you average it between males and females. Subtract 18 and multiply by 52, which, okay, thank you. Okay, is that better? Okay, we're good. Alright, so anyway, subtract 18, multiply by 52, and that gives you about 3,172 marbles. Now, obviously I don't have that many with me. That's more than I can feasibly carry and give a speech. Now, despite this being a formal presentation, I'd like to ask the people in front of me a question, and feel free to respond. I'm actually expecting an answer here. What do you see when you look at me up here giving a speech? Go on, shout it out, it's fine. Okay. Well, this might come as a surprise, but what if I told you that I wasted 2 years of my life doing something that I very much enjoy and most of you will know me for? Okay. Running. Now, this is no fault of Harley's, it's entirely on mine. I started out as a relatively decent cross-country runner, even if Linnea usually beat me in workouts my freshman year. That was funny. But, yeah, I was probably the 5th or 6th varsity runner, depending on the day, but I was probably one of the fiercest runners on the team. If I set my eyes on the back of someone's jersey, there was little chance that I'd let them go. So I ran faster in football, I ran fast races, and ran faster workouts, and repeated the process week after week. And I loved it. I got to see just how far and fast I'd go. I mean, sophomore year, I broke the 3K record by 16 seconds. And, well, that was exactly where it started. Junior year, I had a modest improvement in cross country. 1500 only PR'd by about 2 seconds. Senior year, same thing. Improved slightly in cross country. Not as much as I wanted to, though. That was common between the 2 years. In track, short distance events, I improved a lot in those, but still, not as much as I wanted to. And, well, I kept asking myself, well, why can't I improve like how I wanted to? I mean, what, did I just plateau here or something? That was almost a worry that kept me up at night. But I was out in the woods one day, doing a run. I mean, you'll be hard-pressed to find me running in the city.
Full country person here.
But during that run, I have a lot of time to myself. I asked myself, right before the state meet, did it matter if I broke someone else's record? So I was shooting for the state meet record, which was pretty much a pipe dream. But I asked myself, did it really matter if I broke someone else's record or even placed first? And I honestly had to reply, no. Just because it's not really measuring yourself by others that matters, it's what you think of yourself. I mean, it was a simple reason why I couldn't improve how I wanted to. I was running for things out there, not for what was in here. I got caught up in the accolades and getting in time and just wondering who I could be, who I couldn't, who was going to improve. When in reality, I forgot something very, very important, not just about running, but about life in general. You just have to enjoy it. Let go of what you want to do, let go of what you wish, and just take it as it comes. Because I guarantee you that, at least in front of us, what you think you want to do now might not be what you want to do later. So, guess the moral of the story, keep an open mind. And as many of you will remember, in AP Lang, I constantly preach the concept of nihilism and rejection of external meaning couldn't get enough of it, when in reality, I'd forgotten the first thing about it, that you have to live life enjoying what you do and what you find meaning in, since, I mean, there will come a day when the human race is extinct. It's pretty much inevitable. So it's not so much as what you'll do, as in the buildings you erect, the monuments you build, as it's more of what happens in here, how much you enjoy yourself. So I implore you to devote yourself to what you enjoy, and to warn you that your time is slowly, but steadily, running out. Thank you, class of 2018. It's been a lovely time.
Thanks, John. Hi, my name is Linnea, and I truly have no idea what I'm doing. A lot of you probably think I'm weird. I agree with you. What kind of idiot eats vegetables willingly, runs around in circles for fun, and spends weekends doing homework so they have more time to run around in circles later? Well, that would be me. Not that long ago, I was walking with a couple friends of mine. I forget what it was that we were talking about, but I remember turning to them and saying, if there's an achievement, I want it. And yeah, looking back at it now, I basically summed up my high school experience in a Target parking lot. I honestly couldn't tell you why I'm like this. It's a compulsion, really. I'm simply incapable of backing down from a challenge. There's a cross-country meet I remember vividly, and it wasn't because I ran particularly well. The nervous chatter at the line had ceased, the starter raised his gun, but instead of the usual set command, he said to us, if you fall in the first 100 meters, get back up, this is cross-country. In that moment, I was focused on the race. But standing before you now, I look down and realize that my legs are mapped with scars, commemorating all the times I've fallen and found the courage to keep going. Contrary to what most of you probably think, I do know bad words. But the worst one to me is the one you can say in school, impossible. If I were John, I'd step in and make the critical clarification that it is, in fact, impossible to travel faster than the speed of light. Thankfully, John's speech is over. What I consider impossible is spending 4 years eating kale, running in circles, and reading textbooks without enjoying the challenge of it. I didn't train for the sake of winning medals, and I didn't learn so I could stand on the stage before you today. I did those things for simultaneously the most ridiculous and the most valid reason I can think of. Because I wanted to. I'm well aware that I'm not the most relatable person. But if there's one thing that I hope I can share with you, it's the value of the things that you want to do. If there's one thing that I can say to you, it's that I hope you live your life chasing the things that will leave laughter lines etched in each of your faces. I cannot tell you what those things are, nor can I promise that they'll be easy to pursue, but if you manage to reach them, that, in my mind, is success. Class of 2018, I wish you all the success in the world. Thank you.
I'd like to now welcome SCAPU senior Jordan Coleman to sing a toast.
Tonight the future can wait. So much to prove, nothing left to lose.
ASB President Annabelle Broderick on stage to deliver her message to the class of 2018.
I'm really glad that I put my speech in plastic wrap because of the weather now. As soon as I get on stage, of course, it starts to rain. Good afternoon, everybody. I'm Annabelle Broderick, the student body president here at Scappoose High School. I would first like to say thanks to everyone who came to support the graduating class of 2018. Before I reflect on what the class of 2018 and Scappoose High School has achieved this year, I would first like to recognize some people who have made this year a memorable one for me at SHS. I would like to thank my Lord and Savior for blessing me with this opportunity. Secondly, a special thank you to my grandparents. Thank you. Special thank you to my grandparents and my aunt for always pushing me beyond my abilities, for always taking care of me and giving me the tools to grow and be successful. Also, I would like to thank all my teachers and the staff, two in particular, Courtney Scott for molding me into the leader I am today, also Rebecca Steinke for giving me a taste of what my future at University of Portland School of Nursing will entail. Finally, I would like to thank all my friends, Ben Warren, thank you, for helping me throughout these last 4 years. I expected it to be nicer today considering it only rains twice a year in Oregon, October through April and May through June, and now at our graduation ceremony. When writing my speech, I was contemplating what my overarching theme would be, so what I did and what I always do to get my train of thought rolling is I went for a drive. While blaring Don't Stop Believin' with my best friend Riley Nuss, I started thinking, and here's what I realized. Life is like driving on an open highway. When I get behind the wheel, I feel somewhat in control of my life because I have the ability to go anywhere. That's what we all have the keys to do, to get in the car and drive. Good thing, though, that my driver's test with Mr. Erickson was in an automatic vehicle because shifting gears does not come easy to me. Sorry, Mr. Foster. I have witnessed the drive and perseverance in the class of 2018. Soon, 196 students will walk across this very stage to receive their diplomas. All of these students will be able to deliver something to this world, just like they were able to do this year. And I had a list of everything that we accomplished this year, but Mr. Jones already went through everything that I was going to say, so I'm going to skip that part. But all of those great accomplishments that he mentioned were achieved by members of 2018, so let's give them a hand. Moving forward, there is no doubt in my mind that we will all achieve great things in life after high school. For some of you sitting out in the crowd, you don't know what the future holds, and that's okay. The road to success isn't always a straight shot. There will be times in your life where things are rocky, or you take a wrong turn, or they will set you back. But don't be discouraged. Class of 2018, I hope you all find something you are passionate about, because there's something out there for all of us. Pursue your dreams, work tirelessly until you succeed, overcome obstacles in your path until you reach your goals. There is something that drives us to be the best version of ourselves. So go out there, class of 2018, take the midnight train going anywhere. The journey to success is endless. Don't stop believing that. You will end up somewhere. It has been a pleasure growing up with you all and serving as your student body president. Thank you.
It's a long-standing tradition at SHS for the senior class to select a staff member to speak at graduation. This year, the class of 2018 has selected Scott Deckelman.
First off, I want to thank you for inviting me to speak today. To prepare for this speech, Michelle Parsons suggested I adopt the team motto of the Chicago Cubs from 2016, the year they won the World Series, which was, "Try not to suck." I'll do my best to show. Graduation day is fun for us teachers. Every year on the program you hold in your hands, we circle the names of students we believe will do the craziest things on this stage, and we place bets accordingly. And every year there are favorites. Those we know will be the first with the beach balls and the silly string. And every year we have dark horses. Those that surprise us by backflipping off the stage or bear-hugging a board member. Some staff are really good at picking horses. Harley, Nal, and Bird come to mind. Maybe it's because they're coaches. I don't know. But what I do know is that we teachers like you so much that we compete with one another to show how much we think we know you. This is something special, I think, about this community, about this town, about this school. At SHS, both staff and students take the time to get to know one another. It's this fact that makes the job so enjoyable for me and makes days like this kind of difficult. What I mean to say is that we are all very proud of you today and proud that we've gotten to know you. It seems everyone right now has opinions about what a high school diploma really means. Some say a diploma has lost its use, its relevance. That what you have earned today is nothing but a participation trophy, a piece of paper rewarding you for simply showing up. And maybe they're right, but showing up is really hard. And if I have one piece of advice for you today, it's keep showing up. Showing up requires deciding that something is important to you, like your education, your job, your family, and then deciding to follow through on that promise you've made to yourself. At SHS, when you show up, it makes you obligated to your teachers, your peers, your community. Showing up is doing your science lab on a midnight bus ride home from Astoria by the light of your iPhone. And it's enduring Mrs. Steinke's disappointed face when she explains to you that you've done it wrong again. But it's also showing up to find her during her prep period and asking her for help so that you won't make that mistake again, because you care about doing your best and you care what she thinks of you. Showing up in high school is always tricky. It's always hard. It's always double-edged. Showing up gives you time to find and meet new friends, but also make new enemies. It gives you a chance for public acknowledgement, but also public embarrassment. It gives you an opportunity to be an elite athlete, but also to be cut from the team. But success or achievement has never been a game without risk. It is those that take a risk by regularly showing up that give themselves a chance to achieve something special. Showing up is Aaron Campos, who stepped into the lead role of our school musical with only 4 weeks remaining and performed brilliantly, saving the show. Showing up is Haley Hopkins, who stayed in AP US history after everyone else dropped out. Not because she had to, but because she wanted to see it through. Showing up, Showing up is Leah Bradala, a four-year varsity athlete in track and basketball that also held down a near full-time job so that she could also help out her family. It's Seth Vaughn, it's Victoria Becker, it's Monroe Myers that always seem to be greeting me at my classroom door before and after school, asking me for one more note on their essays. And it's Shannon Wall, who came to school every single day for 4 years. And when you do this consistently, it opens up so much to you and teaches you some of the most important life lessons. It also gives you access to the adults that will show up for you. So that years from now, yes, you'll remember that Miss Erickson taught you that funny quadratic equation song, but more importantly, that she also hounded you about your grades in classes that she never taught you in. And you'll learn to do this for the people you care about. You'll remember that when you took art for Miss Keith or choir for Miss Caldwell, you were part of something special. and you'll learn that some opportunities are fleeting and that you should appreciate the treasures you have while you still have them. I do not know how to find happiness or success. At 40, I still haven't figured that out. But what I have experienced in this job and in my personal life are moments of fulfillment. And I know that showing up for my family, showing up for my friends, and showing up for all of you has given me moments of fulfillment. And that's my challenge to you today. Try not to worry about achieving success or finding happiness. That's a lot to take on. Find out what you want to show up for, and then do it. You don't need a master's degree to show up for people. Do the same work you did to get here. Often it's not exciting, but it always pays off in one way or another. I encourage you to be Ross Parsons, who did win Defensive Player of the Year this past season, but who also showed up every day from January through June, all last year, for voluntary after-school workouts. Be Georgia Jory and Linnea Kubulich, who together worked after school through lunches to resurrect and reignite the school newspaper, The Candle. Be Hadley Enos. After learning that some of the preschoolers qualified for special ed services, Hadley showed up after class to attend meetings with experts from the ESD so that she could learn more, so that she could advocate among her peers for the special rights of children. And be Aiden Steele and Garrett Wood, whose grit and determination this past month and week allowed them to recover the credits they needed to be here today. And even when you commit yourself fully to showing up, I can't guarantee that it will ever feel comfortable. After 12 years here, I still feel like a fake teacher and that everyone else is the real deal. This feeling of insecurity and self-doubt is so common among all humans that they have a name for it: the imposter syndrome. But don't let this feeling keep you from showing up. I say forget the imposter syndrome. Let's try that again. I say forget the imposter syndrome. Embrace the Ryan imposter syndrome. Now, that's a particular condition in which you put a good face, a convincing face, a smiling face on anything, whether you know what you're talking about or not. But it's also a condition in which you make the time to show up for people that matter, even when it isn't in your lesson plan. So in closing, showing up doesn't require smarts or a specific personality. It's a choice you've already made once to get you here. So keep it up. You're all horses worth betting on. Thank you.
School board members and Superintendent Paul Peterson, it is my pleasure to recommend these students for a Scappoose High School diploma. And now, seniors, it's the moment you and your family and friends have all been waiting for, the presentation of diplomas. Class of 2018, please rise and proceed to the stage to receive your diploma.
John Kavulich, Ben Warren, Christine Becker, Carly Reagan, Jordan Coleman, Christina Barnes, Isaiah Bennett, Zach Dickerson, Rosie Menriquez,
Emily Ann Manuel. Monroe Myers. Jade Kearsley. Michael Rhodes. Corey Tobin. Natalie Irwin. John Gross. Christina Perry. Mackenzie Ela. Linnea Kabulich. Nikki Gill. Daniel Nelson. Elizabeth Riuda. Austin Schwalge. Leif Stenzel. Cheyenne Taylor. Jacob Abbott. Joel Abbott. Jesse May Abraham. Trace Ackerl. Emma Alloway. Melanie Bailey. Jason Bailey. Aaron Baker. Alyssa Backinson. Chase Backinson. Caitlin Backinson. Alyssa Baird. Victoria Becker. Chris Bendel. Courtney Hall. Crystal Esterly. Georgia Better. Tyler Begott. Trey Bibscum. Keiko Bongalon. Wyatt Brooks. Ashley Brust. Nathaniel Burbank. Savannah Burke. Jillian Burham. Brody Butler. Aaron Campos. Emily Campos. Grace Comer. Isaac Cook. Brennan Cox. William Cunningham. Grant Dagg. Benji Davidson. Leah Bradala. Cole Davis. Megan Dews. Aaron Dinsmore. Luke Dory Smith. Sierra Dreesen. Jack Eggers. Lucas Elliott. Hadley Enos. Jackson. Hannah Etney. Jacqueline Farmer. Randy Fisher. Taryn Fleming. Sandra Fry. Hannah Gailey. Savannah Ganier. Aaron Gann. Caitlin Gear. Lad Graham. Jake Gray. Gabriel Brog. Jake Haddon. Morgan Hall. Madeline Hall. Hayden Harrison. Josie Head. Cade Higgis. Kelsey Heller. Stephen Hensley. Haley Hopkins. Abigail Hoffman Becker. Riley Horrell. Shasta Howe. Braden Jacobson. Zeddy Jamerson. Tevin Jennis. Ashley Johnson. Jimmy Jones. Georgia Jory. Anna Kangas. George Kilman. Kira Kistner. Madison Kramer. Gabriel Krieger. Jonah Kubeka. Bailey Lair. Shannon Lowell. Parker LeRivier. Gunnar Larson. William Lohman. Savannah Luna. Nathan Mallor. Annabelle Marcantonio. Abigail Martin. Kaylee McGivern. Moses Michelle. Janae Meyer. Tristan Miller. Trinity Miller. Alexander Mitchum. Avery Morley. Megan Moses. Munoz. Soraya Napa'a. Marissa Nelson. Dylan Newcomer. Adam Nickel. Rebecca Nozak. Ashley Oakley. Joshua Odom. Lacey Farrell. Ross Parsons. Danner Kulikowski. Jesse Porter. Michaela Price. Aaron Reardon. Cooper Sears. Malia Sherman. Daphne Slidham. Destiny Smith. Brianna Smith. Megan Smith. Nicholas Sprudy. Aiden Steele. Robin Stewart. Joshua Stofield. Jake Stout. Kinsey Sue. Corbin Tindall. Chris Tobin. Jared Tillman. Stephen Troxel. Jordan Hill. Janston Turner. Jaden Ungerman. Shabri Van Loo. Allison Vanderzanden. Andrew Varga. Vaughn. Bradley Verbout. Caden Berzino. Brannigan Boat. Joey Wagonette. Paris Wallace. Walsh. Rylan Warner. Kylie Weber. Kaylee Wegner. Carson Witt. Garrett Wood. Mackenzie Worthington. Allison Worthington. Joseph Wright. Julia Wright. Julia Wright.
Thank you, parents and guests, for your support and for being here to celebrate our graduation.
Class of 2018, you have now graduated.